Drew and Paul have sailed to the Isle of Wight on the trail of a rust-free Alfa Spider.
Really nice.
Wow, it's unbelievable, actually.
Paul has plans to style it like a miniature Ferrari.
That's the theme. Poor man's California from California.
But if the Spider is going to spin a profit, then Drew needs to drive a bargain.
You're asking what, 14?
Yes.
I was going to say 13. We'll give you 13 and a half and drive it away.
Perfect. Yes, yeah, I can go with that. Yeah.
That was easy.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Yeah,
cheers.
It's a pleasure.
Yeah. All right, great stuff. I'm excited by this car because I've never driven one and I've never owned one. I've never wanted to own one and I've driven it and it's a revelation. What a wonderful little car.
13 and a half grand seems pretty fair to me. Gives us some wiggle room to fix it, make it nice and make a few quid. When we finish, it's going to look so good. It will look like a baby Ferrari California. That car's going to sell.
Safely back on the mainland, Paul hands the Spider to his team of mechanical maestros. First job is to strip out the sun-damaged seats and door cards, while Paul starts the search for his Ferrari-inspired interior.
I've managed to find a supplier here in the UK that, via Italy, can make me some beautiful tan seat covers. Because no one's ever asked for them, they won't make me the door cards. So what I've done to solve this problem, order the tan seat covers, ordered a massive expanse of spare vinyl in exactly the same colour, and we're going to have those made.
As the door cards need to be made from scratch, Paul sent Drew to Sheffield to flex some artistic muscle.
The look and feel we want for this is sort of your mini sort of budget Ferrari, really. So we're going to try and emulate that a little bit. So that means coach trimming. And we're off to see a guy who specialises in classic cars.
Jim King has been tailor-making car interiors for over 30 years and prides himself on delivering work that is completely bespoke.
Some people know what they want and some people are not really sure what they want. They'll say, Jim, how are you going to do that? A bit of test work and bang, experience will get you through.
Jim.
Oh, good morning.
How are you, mate? Some nice motors in.
Yeah.
1303.
Yeah, convertible.
Carman cab.
And built the dash. That's all been done, templated and manufactured.
Nice job. Putting a hood on a Carman cabriolet is very hard. It's a big curve right over. So he's clearly doing very, very difficult work. So I'm glad we found him. Door cards. What I'd like to do is diamond it or pleat it like that all the way through.
Yeah.
Little pocket there for your phone. Drop your phone in.
Right. We'll take the first flute at the angle you want.
That's it.
Yeah.
That's it. So it's just dead straight.
So between that one and that one.
It's really nice working with Jim because he's completely in the same mindset as me. He's like, well, it's going to be about that wide and we'll do this and we'll do that.
Oh, yes. Now you're talking.
It's just tiny, tiny details that overall will improve the car. Oh, yeah. That's lovely. And can you make me a tonneau cover?
Certainly can.
And pipe the floor mats in that as well.
Yes.
So what sort of money are we looking at?
Best part of 1,500, I'd have thought.
That's fine with me for all
of
that.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for being in touch.
All the best.
Thank you, mate. £1,500, that's all right. That's fine. That's not a lot of money because we're not spending a fortune on this car, but what we are doing will make a big difference and it will change the aspect of this car forever.
With Drew's design fresh in his mind, Jim cracks on with the job.
Right then, these are the old trims. So use that as your template for handles, window winders, and mark them out onto your new board.
Each door card is made from a piece of carefully cut hardboard. That creates a base for Jim's intricate fabric work.
Yeah, nice and steady and keep the lines nice and straight. Back staple this, so when we fold this back, it's gonna give us a nice crisp line. And the same principle on the bottom. And there we go. One door panel done. There's the pocket. And that fits in there snug.
And in Stratford-upon-Avon, wood turner Phil Irons is making a bespoke gear knob to replace the mismatched aftermarket one that came with the car.
I'm a real stickler for shape and form, especially something as tactile as a gear knob. The best shapes are always, you've got the rule of thirds, so the largest diameter is a third of the way down the piece. It's a bit like cutting hair. Once you've taken it off, you can't put it back on again.
Phil is going to use a darker wood for the top of the gear knob.
What I want to do is put a contrasting piece of ebony in the top. with the shift pattern engraved on it.
With the shape of the gear knob complete, the cracks in the wood are filled with molten pewter.
Rather than trying to disguise the faults, if you like, in the wood, make a feature of them. So now I just use a file to get rid of the excess. And I'm happy with that.
The shift pattern is laser etched and then given the same molten pewter treatment as the knob.
Well, I'm very pleased with the overall effect. We've got these tiny little streaks of pewter where it's gone into the end grain of the ebony. It highlights the fact that it is wood. So I'm really, really pleased with how that's come out. This is the bit that I find exciting when you put your finish on. The wood really stands out.
Back at the workshop, the outside of the Spider is also undergoing some changes. The Italian Alfa Romeo aftermarket is thriving, and Paul has managed to track down a more muscular set of alloy wheels. And once the bespoke gear knob and tan interior are in place, the finished car is ready to roll.
I have to say, I am delighted with how this car came together. I never doubted it. It was such a good car when we bought it, but the little things we've done, this new interior, the wheels, the tyres, the headlights, even this gear knob, everything just makes this car such a nice place to be. So it's going to show Drew now. Hello, mate.
Wow. Look at that. That looks incredible.
Like it?
That's beautiful.
You can always gauge Drew's reaction by the first thing he does, and I've turned up, there's a big grin, a little clap of the hands. I think I've smashed it.
The car just looks transformed. A bit more racy, it's a lot more grown up. It looks a hell of a lot more expensive than it really is. That is a quality in most things that you'll want to look for.